Thank you. So the goal is to then not be dead by daylight, right? Word to live by. Oh, hi. I didn't see you come in. I'm Bruce Campbell, best known as Ash Williams from Ash vs. Evil Dead. Good news. You get to play Ash as a survivor in the hit video game Dead by Daylight. Be Ash and survive. Okay, got it? Good. Now, my agent told me once I completed my contractual obligations that you had a little something-something for me. This isn't tequila, but what the fuck? Get somebody on the phone.
Thank you. For the past 3 years, players have been taken into the realms of the Entity. Soon, a new experience will bring them deeper in, revealing unspoken secrets of the past as they meet the torments of the present. Welcome to the Archives. A brand new feature available to all players, which deepens the Dead by Daylight experience, with new challenges and unique rewards issued every mid-chapter. Each release includes a tome and a rift. The tome provides free content, unlocked by players as they complete challenges. Different paths lead to different rewards. It's up to the players to choose what they want to unveil. The tome is always available and can be completed at any time. And there's more. Introducing the Rift, which provides even more free content. And with an exclusive Rift Pass, unlock access to premium rewards. The Rift starts at the beginning of a new tome and is only available for a limited time. After that, it will be closed for good. Each new tome will provide new challenges and rewards, expanding the world of Dead by Daylight. Journey deeper into the fog this October.
What is fate but a series of moments and choices that define our lives? Roses we want to remember and thorns we can never forget. Futile as the thought experiment is, I sometimes wonder where I would be had I made different choices. There's a moment in all of our lives when our choices catch up to us. A moment that changes us forever. A moment of reckoning. Doesn't always go the way we plan. How many times have I witnessed emotions lead people astray? How many times could a tragedy have been avoided with a little patience, a little reflection, a little common sense? How many times have pride and anger destroyed or changed lives in ways no one expected or imagined? Sometimes taking a moment to reflect before emotions escalate changes everything. Humans are capable of wondrous achievements because of their unique ability to feel, empathize, and dream. Without these qualities, without empathy, without feeling, without our humanity, we are like any other animal species fighting for territory, resources, survival. But unlike any other species, humans have a great imagination for death, cruelty, and mass murder. And an even greater capacity to enjoy their destructiveness. It is in our most trying times that we must hold on to our humanity with unwavering conviction, lest we become the very thing we hate and plunge into a personal hell of infinite night. The destructive instinct. Fighting, torturing, killing. Experiences buried deep within our hearts, waiting for the slightest provocation to be unleashed. Yet looking closer, we sometimes find a passion not for destruction, but for something else. Something far more creative, intricate, and complex. When the scales of justice are corrupt, the creative instinct rouses within us a need for expression, a need for retribution, a need to shed blood for years of unpunished abuse, suffering, and cruelty. It becomes not an act of destruction, but an act of creation. It becomes a work of art.
Yeah.
Life is a paradox. Change one thing, change everything. We are but walking contradictions of past, present, and future selves. A saint in one world, a killer in another, and both true and not true at the same time. If I could go back, would I change anything? Would I do things differently, knowing that the slightest change could trigger a snowball that tumbles and grows? To become an avalanche of death and destruction. How hard we struggle to hide from the darkness behind a curtain of civilization. How hard we struggle to protect the light of civilization with our laws, flags, and weapons of mass destruction. But eventually, the curtain falls. And darkness returns to smother us all.
Thank you.
Stories are everything. We use them to understand our relationships, our sense of self, our reality. They bring us joy, insight, and inspiration. They teach us, build us, and empower us. Stories are the elixir of the soul, but they can also be a poison, defeating us, destroying us, corrupting us, keeping us in an endless loop of pain and suffering. Sometimes the only way to escape is to find another story. The right story.